Welcome back to part three of our series of how to declutter your house in 30 days. Only 5 more days tasked to the finish line, so let's get going. Next up is the garage. Everyone seems to dread this step, but don't worry, we're going to take this slow and methodical to avoid getting overwhelmed. If you follow the steps so far, you're already a little ahead of the game by having those keep items that we boxed and marked already that we've talked about for the past 25 days. For the first 2 days of the garage process, you'll need a large space to use temporarily for the sorting part of this task. Your driveway would be a perfect place. Divide your space into sections. You'll be emptying out everything so you can see what you have. These sections will keep you from feeling overwhelmed. If you already have shelving in your garage, great! There's no need to empty those right now. Divide your spaces into lawn gear, tools or workbench items area, and recreational storage like bikes or skis. Make distinct sections that make sense to what you use your garage for. At this point, don't worry about being organized. Just place all like items together in those sections. Empty everything, one section at a time. Divide your stuff into keep or give away. Now go get the rest of the stuff that you've already boxed for storage over the past 25 days. Is there anything that you'd rather give away now? Adjust accordingly. At the end of day 27, dispose of all items in your giveaway or your trash piles. Phew! I know those first 2 days of the garage process must seem like the hardest so far. Reward yourself for completing this largest job. For some of you, that might mean that you could park your car in the garage tonight. Congratulations! You are on the downhill slide now. Group light things together and assess your inventory. Once you see what you're working with, purchase storage containers that fit your needs. On day 29, sort, stack, and label. And be amazed! You've made it to day 30. Now let's tie up those loose ends now. Now that you've created a space for everything and everything in its place, let's do something about keeping that mail from piling up on your clutter-free counters. Sort through your mail and unsubscribe to those useless catalogs. Separate the rest into bills, personal, invitations, things like that. Then consider getting an organizer tray, or better yet, get one of those mail sorters that neatly hang on the wall. Here's a tip. To opt out for all that junk mail, just call toll-free 1-888-5-OPT-OUT or go to www.optoutprescreen.com. And lastly, keep it clean. Set aside 20 minutes each day to sort through your mail and put things in its place. Try not to buy things just because they're on sale, remembering how good decluttered feels. And especially if you're thinking about selling, you're now ahead of the game. And by the way, if you'd like a printable, shareable copy of How to Declutter Your House in 30 Days, along with all 3 videos in this series, just head over to my website. You'll find a link below that I placed in the description for you. At the end of day 30, it's time to celebrate. You did it. You organized and decluttered your entire house in 30 days. Take pride and bask in your newly organized and simplified house, remembering how great being decluttered feels. I'm Lisa Kelly, and thank you for taking the time to join me today. Be safe, my friends. And remember to stay positive and proactive during this time. I know together we'll all get through this. Until then, I look forward to seeing you on the next one.